Well, it will be very difficult for an independent commission to make a finding of fraud against the sorts of individuals who were involved, both in relation to Manchester City, but also the third parties involved. And proving that in this forum, I think, will be a challenge. So that will be the hurdle that the Premier League has set itself up with a very high bar. And accordingly, to succeed on the most serious matters, are going to effectively have to say that City have created false accounts for the best part of a decade. And that will be clearly a very, very difficult call for any independent commission to make in a forum of this nature. But if they do, clearly the consequences are very serious for Manchester City. I think it will reflect in many ways the defence that they raised at CAS in respect of the UEFA charges that came in a number of years ago, based on the same underlying leak or hack from the German press. But I think now supplemented with a much wider disclosure bundle within this case. So I would expect there to be many hundreds of thousands of pages of documents in play for the hearing. City's defense fundamentally will be that they didn't carry out any of the misdemeanors that are alleged, and that the accounts are as audited over the last 10 years, 15 years, and therefore effectively City have not done any of the alleged misdemeanors. So fundamentally, it will be around about denying that the sponsor revenue has been put into the club by way of equity, and secondly, that those individuals who are witnesses and were involved did not carry out what they are alleged to have carried out, and ultimately, the independent commission will have to take a view as to whether they believe those witnesses, and whether the documents themselves tell a different story. So, at one extreme, if everything went against City in respect of all of the charges, then you can expect the most serious penalties imaginable, because effectively it would have been established that over a very long period, City had systematically false accounted in terms of the major part of their revenue being the sponsor revenue from Abu Dhabi partners. So it would be extremely serious if all of the charges were proven, and therefore I think you can expect in the realms of relegation or a points deduction that equated to relegation at that extreme. At the other extreme, on if it was let's say City were only found to have breached the cooperation requirements within the Premier League rules, I think it would be very hard for the Premier League to sustain a sporting sanction for something like that, because there will have been no sporting advantage. And what we've seen both from the Everton and the Nottingham Forest cases are that the independent commissions tend to focus on sporting sanction where sporting advantage has been confirmed. And as I say, I think it's unlikely that the Premier League would be able to argue that sporting sanction was an appropriate sanction for non-cooperation. It feels that would more likely end in a financial penalty as opposed to a sporting sanction. But I think we've seen both from the Everton and the Nottingham Forest cases that the submissions that are made by the Premier League tend to be quite aggressive in terms of what they expect these independent commissions to put in place in terms of sanctions. You know, we know, for example, that on the original Everton case, they wanted a 12-point deduction initially. And so I would fully expect the Premier League's barrister to be pushing very, very hard for very serious punishment, notwithstanding the damage or the potential damage commercially that might do to the Premier League in the short term. But we'll just have to see. I mean, we are a little bit beyond that because we are now clearly they made the charges in last year. There's been a very, very expensive legal process that's gone on to get us to this point. And then you will have what appears to be a very long hearing to assess very serious allegations of wrongdoing by Manchester City. So we are a little bit beyond it, I think, in terms of trying to keep this all politically very quiet and commercially in a place where the Premier League can't lose. I think the truth is the Premier League it could well lose if it wins the case. The reality is, a lot of the key decisions will be made by the Independent Commission, having heard the evidence. Because even if the decision of the Independent Commission is appealed, it is going to be extremely difficult for Manchester City or the Premier League to challenge any findings of fact of that panel, because the panel are going to hear the evidence. An appeal is not a retrial, so the appeal will not rerun the entire trial with all the evidence. And therefore, within the decision made by the panel, you can expect them to come up with a conclusion in respect of what actually happened. And unfortunately for both parties, they will be stuck with those findings of fact and will have to work around them in any appeal. So the appeal is most likely to be around the ideas of either mistakes, outright mistakes by the initial panel, or really challenging the sanction levels and penalties and punishments that are set out within the initial decision. So there's no question that the initial hearing is absolutely critical to both sides. Reality is we don't know. I mean, this is all uncharted territory. So you have to understand that there are numerous problems that could flow from this. First of all, we don't know when the decision will be made. If this really is a 10 to 12 week hearing, we can expect it to take 3, 6, even 12 months for a decision to be made by an independent panel. And then you've got the possibility of an appeal. And I would say the probability of an appeal if City were to be unsuccessful in defending the claim, because they're so serious, the charges and the likely sanctions, that City are bound to appeal if they lose. So this could go on for some time. Then there's the question of exactly what happens and when, in terms of a relegation, as you say, whether the EFL would accept a Premier League club in these circumstances, whether they would have a different view, and whatever else in terms of sanction is put in place by the Premier League panel. So I think we can't be too specific in terms of how it's all going to play out and the timings because we just don't know. But clearly, the sorts of issues that you've touched on there will probably be things that are going to have to be thought about and dealt with, but that won't necessarily be easily within the powers of the Independent Commission considering the case.